Nnamdi Kanu tenders heartfelt apology to Southeast leaders. Constructive criticism is one of the hallmarks of vibrant opposition in every democratic setting. Besides, the practice of modern representative democracy is arguably unthinkable without having a die-hard opposition. A healthy opposition must be on ground to monitor, caution, and redirect erring leaders before they leap into the threshold of authoritarianism. When insincere leaders tremble at every minor criticism and start persecuting dissent voices, then freedom of expression will be in jeopardy. Renowned leaders who succeeded during their epoch paid attention to wise counsel and were never flippant with words. They were men of few words but traced with unquantifiable action. This expository analysis is born out of love and concern for the leader of IPOP, who mischievously felt that freedom fighting can be approximated to a one-man show. By sitting on his franchise radio to bank, malign and abuse leaders of thought in the Southeast region, he thought his utopia nation will emerge spontaneously from the sky. Needless to say that he is a man that is fighting a good fight but with wrong approach. Freedom fighting is not a one-man business. It takes the collective efforts of the oppressed people to overcome the oppressors. Nnamdi Kanu by now must have learned his bitter lessons. Experience must have taught him that in the art of freedom fighting, one must curry the complete support of all and sundry to succeed. Kanu squandered his goodwill by abusing and devouring into pieces individuals who would have given him the needed logistic for his mission. That was why when the caliphate devourers came, there was no one to stand for him. The people who were supposed to protect him went back to their shells because of his constant blackmail against them. Leaders of thought in the southeast of Nigeria for the past 5 years have been battered and treated like chickens shit by Nnamdi Kanu and his overzealous thugs, masquerading as followers. Elders from the region are now a laughingstock in the eyes of everyone. Respect, unfortunately, has been thrown to the dogs, all because a man on his malicious radio told them the elders are Fulani slaves. Our brainwashed youth took it upon themselves to hunt down their fathers for immediate execution. What a confused generation. The grave wound IPOP and Nnamdi Kanu have inflicted on Ndibo will take many years to heal. The quest for power and control made the same IPOP to ambush Senator Ike Ekweremadu at Germany and molested him. A distinguished senator was humiliated and tossed around. Instead, Nnamdi Kanu to reprimand his rampaging talks, he mounted on the radio and began to brag and appreciated the scandals that attack Ekweremadu. Not only that, he repeated with so much audaciousness that what happened to Ike Ekweremadu was a tip of an iceberg. On the same toxic radio, he threatened Ohaneze Ndigbo not to hold any gathering again and anybody that tears him, the face is wrought. What a man, what a dictator. Thank you for listening to this news. Now, let me tell this writer, first and foremost, I would like to correct this writer at first. Nnamdi Kanu is not a dictator, alright? He's not a dictator. He tells you what he feels that is likely to happen. You check it. All that Nnamdi Kanu has been revealing and been telling you people in Nigeria since the year 2017. Is it not what you people are experiencing and also seeing coming to pass? Is it not? So why are you saying that he's a dictator? Who has he detected for? Who has he detected for? Nnamdi Kanu is not a dictator. He's a type that welcome ideas, opinions, and that is why he has been able to take Biafran up to the level it is today. If he is not the type that welcome other ideas, he wouldn't have gotten tangible people and respected people around him to support his pursuit for Biafran naturalization. It's because of his humble nature and his intelligence that has made a lot to want to be around him and support him, both physically and financially. He is not weak. He is always very, very strong. Do you understand? And besides, the apology that he rendered is not an apology of plead. He rendered an apology so that he is a good son from a good parent with good manners. Do you understand? That is why he has done what he just did. So a Nigerian government will know that Nnamdi Kanu and the IPOPs are good people with good personality, not what they are thinking. He did not apologize because he is afraid. Nnamdi Kanu can never be afraid. Instead of being afraid, he will face his fears and make sure that he conquers. If he has been afraid, all the while that Nigerian government has been threatening him, it is even enough for him to say, I'm not doing it again. Please, I want to drop Biafra. But instead of him to be scared and, you know, running away, he kept pushing out, he kept getting motivated and kept believing that Biafran will be actualized. And today Biafran is where it is today because of Nnamdi Kanu. So let he that have ear to hear, Nnamdi Kanu did not plead because he's afraid. He plead because he wants people to know that he is a good son from a good parent and he is well trained. Do you understand? So, my viewers, based on all that has just been said, what do you think? What is your own observation and your own take? Deem it fit to leave your comments below the comment box. Click on the subscription buttons as well as the bell buttons to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.